Hello students, the topic we are discussing in this session is Miller indices. The crystal planes are known by their orientations with respect to crystallographic axis. In 1839, W.H. Miller formulated a mathematical method of designating the position and orientation of a crystal plane in terms of three integers enclosed in a parenthesis. He suggested that it is more useful to describe the orientation of a plane by the reciprocal of its numerical parameters rather than by its lattice parameters. We know that the unit cell of a crystal is represented by three basis vectors and three interfacial angles. Rather than representing in terms of lattice parameters, it is more useful if we represent a crystal plane using the reciprocal of its numerical parameters. On the basis of this suggestion, Miller formulated a set of three integers which are called as Miller indices. When these reciprocals, when converted into whole numbers, HKL, represented in within the parenthesis, they are popularly called as Miller indices. A set of three integers which are used to represent the plane are referred to as Miller indices. Now let us understand the procedure to find the Miller indices of a lattice plane in a cubic crystal. To find the Miller indices of a plane, we may adopt the following procedure. The first step involves determining the intercepts of the plane along the three crystallographic axes in terms of lattice parameters. We have three crystallographic axes along A bar, B bar and C bar. First, find the intercepts made by the plane along the three crystallographic axes. The second step, divide these intercepts by the appropriate unit translation vectors or the basis vectors. The basic magnitude of basis vectors are A, B, C. The intercept along the x direction, that is along the basis vector A bar, is divided by A. Along B bar is divided by B, and the intercept along C bar is divided by C. We get three numbers. Take the reciprocal of these three numbers. If the reciprocal results in a fraction, then multiply each of them by the smallest common divisor to get a whole number. The fractions are converted into whole numbers by multiplying each of them by smallest common divisor. The last step, put the resulting integers in a lunar bracket, that is within the parenthesis, HKL within the parenthesis, to get the required Miller indices of the given plane or any set of planes parallel to it. We can represent the given plane or any set of planes parallel to the given plane can be represented by the same set of Miller indices. Now let us understand this procedure with the help of a simple illustration. Let us consider a crystal in which a plane cuts the intercepts 2A, 3B and 6C along the three crystallographic axes. To find the Miller indices, let us apply the procedure already described. The first step involves finding the intercepts. They are already given. The intercept along the x-axis is 2A, y-axis 3b and z-axis 6c. In case of a cubic crystal, we can take the XYZ axis itself as the crystallographic axis. So, along X-axis, the intercept is 2A, Y-axis it is 3B, and along Z-axis it is 6C. Now, second step is divide the intercepts by corresponding unit translational vectors or unit translations. That is, the x-intercept is divided by A, y-intercept is divided by B, z-intercept is divided by C. So, the x-coordinate will result in the number 2, y-intercept will result in 3, z-intercept will result in 6. The third step is take the reciprocal of these numbers. The first one is 1 by 2, second number is 1 by 3. This will result in 1 by 6. Since the reciprocals results in the fraction, if you get the fraction, clear the fraction by multiplying the each one with LCM. Now, for these numbers, the LCM is 6. So, divide each number by 6. So, that will result in 3, 2, 1. After clearing the fractions, we get 3, 2, 1. These three integers put within the parenthesis gives us the required Miller indices of the plane. In this particular example, the Miller indices are 3, 2, 1. Note that these three numbers should be represented without any space, without any punctuation marks such as dot or comma or any symbol. They are represented as a continuous number and it should not be read as 321, but we have to read it as 3, 2, 1 plane. Here we have some typical examples of crystal planes represented with their Miller indices. This plane is the plane 100. The second figure, this is the plane having the Miller indices 100. This plane is the plane 110 plane. This is 11 plane. This is, next one is 200 plane. The next one is 112 plane. Now let us understand one of them. Now observe here, this plane is parallel to both y-axis as well as z-axis. Suppose if we take this as x-axis, this is the y-axis, this is the z-axis. Since we are considering a cubic crystal, for cubic crystal, all the three angles alpha, beta, gamma are 90. So the in crystallographic axis is same as that of coordinate axis XYZ. Now, this plane makes one unit along X direction. So, its reciprocal will be 1. The intercept made by the plane with YZ are infinity. If any plane is parallel to a particular axis, the corresponding intercept is taken as infinity, and the corresponding, since the intercept is infinity, the reciprocal of this one is equal to 0, the Miller index of the corresponding axis is taken as 0. In this example, this plane 100 plane is parallel to both y-axis and z-axis. The corresponding intercepts are infinity, so the corresponding Miller indices are 0, 0. So this plane represents 100 plane. Now observe the second figure. Here the plane cuts both x-axis as well as y-axis but parallel to z-axis. So the corresponding z-intercept is infinity and the Miller indices L is equal to 0, 110. Now the third figure, this plane cuts all the three axes X, Y, Z. So, we have the intercepts 1, 1, 1 along the 3 axis. The reciprocals are also 1, 1, 1. Since the reciprocal itself is a whole number, no need to clear the fraction. We get 1, 1, 1 plane. Here, we have one more typical example, XYZ. This cuts off the intercept of A along x-axis but parallel to y and z. As we discussed already, the intercepts along y and z axis are infinity. So this plane, since the intercept is of A, then taking the reciprocal we get number 2. So the h index is the 2, y index is k index is 0, l index is 0. So hkl values are 2, 0, 0. Now let us understand the importance of Miller indices. We know that Miller indices for a plane can be determined by taking the reciprocal of the numerical parameters. The question arises, why we have to take the reciprocals? Let us understand the purpose of taking the reciprocal. The purpose of taking the reciprocals is to find the Miller indices, is to bring all the planes inside a single unit cell so that all the crystal planes can be interpreted in terms of the planes passing through a single unit cell. As the entire crystal can be generated from this single unit cell, it is studied as a representative of the whole crystal. Now let me explain this. Now if we go on representing each plane with a different set of Miller indices, that becomes complicated. So what Miller thought is, if we take the reciprocal of these numerical parameters, then all the crystal planes can be brought into a single unit cell. It represents the least possible numbers. The reciprocals gives us the least possible numbers. So all the planes can be brought into a single unit cell so that all the crystal planes can be interpreted in terms of this single unit cell. And we already learned that a unit cell is the representative of the entire crystal. So just by finding the representing the planes within a single unit cell, we can understand the complete crystal structure. So this is the purpose of taking reciprocals. Now let us understand some common notations used in representing the Miller indices. H, K, L within the parenthesis represents a lattice point in space. Here the commas are used to signify that it represents the lattice points. HKL within the parenthesis without any commas or dots, any punctuation marks, represents a plane. It represents the plane in a crystal. If we represent HKL in a flower bracket, it represents a family of equivalent planes. As we discussed already, there are many set of planes which are equivalent to each other. Such set of equivalent planes are represented with a single set of HKL values within the flower bracket. The direction of a crystal plane can be represented by HKL put within a square bracket. If you put a square bracket, then that represents the direction. Note that the values of HKL will be the same for both the crystal plane as well as direction. The difference is the plane is represented by parentheses while the directions are represented by square brackets. The angular brackets HKL values represented within the angular bracket represents a family of equivalent directions. Just like flower bracket represents the family of equivalent planes, the corresponding equivalent directions are represented by HKL put within angular bracket. Now, while understanding the Miller indices so far, just we considered the intercepts in the positive directions. Suppose if we move to the negative directions, then the corresponding indices are will have the negative values. Those negative values of Miller indices are represented by putting a bar over it. For example, bar 1, 1, 0. Here, the x-intercept is along negative direction. The plane cuts the x-axis in the negative direction. The negative Miller indices are represented by putting a bar over the corresponding index. If the intercept of a plane is infinity, that is, if a plane is parallel to any particular axis, the corresponding intercept is infinity, and the index, Miller index corresponding to this intercept is taken as zero. These are some common notations used in representing the Miller indices. Now let us understand some significant features of Miller indices of a crystal plane. The Miller index notation especially useful for cubic crystal systems. The desirable of Miller indices for a cubic crystals, the desirable features of Miller indices for a cubic crystal are listed below. The first one, the Miller indices having the same ratio. If the Miller indices have the same ratio, then the planes are parallel to each other. Now, for example, we have three set of planes, 844, 222, 211. Now, all these three planes are parallel to each other. A set of parallel planes will have Miller indices with the same ratio. Miller indices does not just define a particular plane, but it represents a set of equally spaced parallel planes. For example, here we have three different planes, but having the same ratio. All the three represents the same set of parallel planes, or they can be represented by a single set of Miller indices. The next point, all equidistant parallel planes have the same Miller indices and vice versa. If the Miller indices are same, the planes are parallel to each other, or if the planes are parallel to each other, there can be represented by same set of Miller indices. It is only the ratio of indices which is more important in this concept of Miller indices. That is, 622 plane is same as that of 311 plane. Just already we discussed this point. So, this plane 622 is represented by 311 plane itself. A crystal plane parallel to one of the crystallographic axes has the intercept at infinity and its index is zero for that axis. A plane passing through the origin is defined in terms of parallel plane having non-zero intercepts. If any plane passes through the origin, then that plane is represented in terms of a plane parallel to it having the non-zero intercepts. If the plane cuts the axis on the negative side of the origin, then the corresponding Miller index is negative. The negative indices are represented by putting a bar over the index. Bar 1, 0, 0, 0, bar 1, 0, 0, 0, bar 1, etc. The Miller indices of crystal direction is represented by a square bracket. This point already we discussed. In a cubic crystal, the direction HKL is normal to the plane H, but this is not true in case of other crystal systems. In case of cubic crystal systems, we can represent the direction as normal to the crystal plane. This is only in the case of cubic crystal. A full set of equivalent planes in a crystal are represented by Miller indices enclosed in braces or the flower brackets instead of parentheses. Similarly, full set of equivalent directions in a crystal are represented by angular bracket. These are some of the significant features of Miller indices.